It's pizza time, dough edition. I'm showing you how to mix your starter. What do you need to get your starter going? Not a whole lot. What I got going here, most importantly, the culture. For simplicity, we're just gonna call it the culture during this series. Some people call this the starter or the Levant. And same thing with what we're gonna mix up. That can be called the starter Levant. It depends. Pizza people, bread people, it goes all over the place. It can get confusing. I feel you on that. My culture, I built this one using the Ken Forkish recipe from Elements of Pizza. It's one I like a lot. It's really simple, straightforward, with not a whole lot of going on to it, which is really good because it shouldn't be super complicated. And one thing I really like about it doesn't use a lot of flour. Some recipes out there, you can end up, tossing a lot of flour is the unfortunate reality of it. We're always like to minimize waste. It's never a good thing to be wasting anything. And especially when you're using, I always try and use really good flours in my mixes, organic, and it's not the cheapest. So tossing that stuff out, I'm not having a good time. Also really important with that flour thing, as I read comments online, people having trouble building that culture. I think more than anything, sometimes it comes down to that flour that they're using in the mix. It's really important to have some life in that stuff. So, you're using a whole wheat, make sure it's really good quality, organic, fresh. You're gonna have a lot better results because a lot of what is making your culture get, blossom up and become alive just as we like it. You always hear it's like, oh, it was, foraged in this air somewhere. There is truth to that for sure. And it's a whole lot of fun too. But a lot of that just is coming right off the flour itself. So that could be your problems oftentimes. Always use the best flour. And that's what I got going here. I got 100 grams of, today I'm using bread flour. This is another opportunity where I'm presenting this series as just kind of a guide to get you started on your own dough journey, your own process, so you can develop, kind of tinker with it and make your own thing. So this is one spot that you can do it. I'm always coming in with 100 grams, but that 100 grams may vary. Like I said, today, this is just bread flour. It's malted bread flour, which I like using too. Got some, I feel like that helps with the enzyme activity, really good, but use what you like just to make sure it's good, because I think you're gonna have more luck with your starter. And then also, we got the water. Nothing secret going on here. I'm using filtered water, 100 grams of water. I just pulled out, it's room temperature today. If it was really warm out, I might actually just cool it down, throw some ice cubes in there before I start, or if it's really cold, I might warm it up, maybe like 85 degrees. And the water thing, you hear this crazy stuff, people flying in water from places. I wouldn't stress too hard on it. I think it's good to use the filtered water, but in reality, a lot of really good pizzerias out there are just pulling straight from the tap, nothing fancy, just the municipal water. It's good stuff, don't worry about it, but go filtered, I'm into that. And then I got it all mixed up. If you've been around a little bit, a deli container is like one of life's greatest things. That's what I use for so much stuff. You don't need to keep your starter or your culture in anything fancy. I'm usually swapping this one out too, just to keep it nice and clean when I'm feeding this thing. I pull it out, just 25 grams or, that's what I'm usually shooting for, 25 grams left. I'll pull that out, put it in a fresh container, feed that, once a week, even sometimes up to 2 weeks. Not stressing on it too hard. Also, I got my scale. If you're doing anything serious in the kitchen, get yourself a scale. It's one of the most useful things. Doing life by weight in many ways is just a really good thing. Weigh your shiz. That's how you know what's up. And it's great for baking. Also, for stuff that blew my mind when I first got into the kitchen and seeing like, oh, you can do your, big pieces of meat, weigh that stuff out. You can calculate out your salt by percentage. Then everybody has well-flavored food. I'm into it. Let's get this mixed up. So it's real simple here. I already pulled 50 grams of the starter, culture, into the 100 grams of water. I just mixed it up by hand or with a spoon, you could do it too. Just making sure, there's a couple little chunks in there, but I'm getting it mostly mixed into that water. And then I'm just gonna add 100 grams of flour into the mix. You can go the hand method is a pretty good one, but I'm trying to keep it, nice and clean here on camera, not making a big mess. So I'm going with the spoon. And also I was reading, I don't know if you guys know that book, the Tassajara bread book. That's one of the books that initially got me into baking and bread and that sort of stuff. It's a fun one, and it's like the recipes in there are pretty loose. Like it'll be like, oh, anywhere between a cup and 5 cups or something, and then like oddly specific on other stuff. Like go for 100 turns of the spoon when mixing up your sponge, which is kind of similar to a starter. So I'm going with 100 today. It's a fun book if you ever checked it out. It's a good one to like, it's a little bit old school, and that simple bread that's in there, it's not really like the new wave sourdough, but it's a lot of fun. I'm gonna get this thing, I'm hopefully getting my count right so I get exactly 100. I'm gonna get it all mixed up. I'm just gonna cover it, let it sit at room temperature. And this is another part that you gotta start learning your environment, your culture, your starter, to see how it works where you're at. It could be anywhere. I'm looking at for it to about double in size. That's why another handy thing, just a simple rubber band. After I get this mixed up, I'm gonna eye it right on there where it is so I can keep track. I'm looking for it to about double. It's pretty warm today. I'm thinking it maybe even can do it in just a matter of hours, maybe 6 hours, check back. But you know, sometimes I'm doing it overnight. I feel for how I do my dough mix, probably a good way to start is either mix up your starter in the evening or late night, then do your next mix the next morning. Or another way you could do it is when you get up in the morning, make your starter mix, go do your thing, tend your crops, whatever you do during the day, and then come back, everything's doubled, and then you can do the rest of your mix. I'm gonna finish off with my full 100 turns, get this thing covered up into the dough nook. We'll be back. Hope you guys are enjoying the series. Hope I can help you on your dough journey and following and finding your pizza dreams so you can create your own beautiful pizzas. One love.